Dragonfly Gamer UK, and we are back in Stationeers on Europa. In the last session, we built a deep miner. That's it here. I need to still connect up the power and the chutes that will be connected to a centrifuge, likely to be a combustion centrifuge, just up here or possibly here, so the ore's fed into my base. We also built ourselves a heavy miner, which allows us to really quickly cleared earth and dirt away, or ice in this case, as well in Europa. As you can see, it's so much quicker than the original drill you start with. And this just aids us in our mining. I'm clearing this space out here so I can possibly get a second deep miner installed somewhere around here. We also installed some solar panels to see how much energy we could collect from the sun. It's not a great deal, but it's better than these when these are just turning us slowly. One thing I'd like to clarify is that I have always boxed my furnaces in like this with a frame around them. It used to be that this completely insulated the furnace and you didn't lose any heat out of it. That has been changed by the developers, and if I show you, temperature of the furnace 205. 204, it is going down slowly, so it is losing heat. However, without the frame, it will still lose heat, but you'll see it will be much quicker. So if we just take the frame off, you can now see that temperature is dropping a lot quicker. Yeah, it's dropping down 1 degree a second there, where before it was 1 degree every 4 or 5 seconds. So that's why I box the furnace in, just to stop that constant bleed, or to reduce the speed of that loss of heat out of the furnace. Put that back. Bring our tablet back. Actually, it's about 10 seconds between degrees. It will vary depending on the heat of the furnace and the heat of the surrounding area. So somewhere like Europa, where it's extremely cold, you lose heat quicker than if you're on Vulcan, say. But just be aware, it is still worth boxing in your furnace, as it does reduce the heat loss. So in this session, I want to look at setting up the centrifuge outside, and also maybe add some more solar panels along that side. Actually, I'm going to quickly go and check how those panels are doing. 93 watts, 91 watts, and the sun's actually gone past the zenith, so that power will be dropping off. So it's up to about 140 watts, I think it's peaking at. I wonder if I can get a tracking solar panel on there. First things first, let's look at the centrifuges. Now, there's two different types of centrifuge you can use. There is a combustion centrifuge, which is this one, which takes fuel in at the back and has a exhaust outlet. Waste caution. Dirty ore comes this side and you get the clean ore out that side. It takes 50 watts to run, but it does need fuel. The other one is just a normal centrifuge. Now this one takes 100 watts, so it's more power consumption, and it's much slower, but doesn't require any fuel. But as we have the fuel farm set up, we may as well build the combustion centrifuge. So, I think it's in here. Combustion centrifuge, what do we need? We need constantan, invar, and steel. There's a constantan. There's the invar. Where's the steel? In you. So let's just set that going. How's our room doing? 25 degrees. How are our plants doing? Thriving, 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 and thriving. Okay, they're all doing okay. What's the CO2 levels in here? That's the other thing I need to keep an eye on. CO2 is 8.6%, that's fine. If it does drop, we can always, and you know what, let's just blast a little bit out here. You may remember in our previous videos we actually recovered a tank of CO2 from a furnace. What's that done to the atmosphere? 10.3, that's a little bit better. And we have 234 moles left in there. Okay, so they're doing okay, that's good. That sun's gone in already, see? How are we doing power wise? 420 coming in, over a K going out. Kilowatt, that is, sorry. And there's our combustion centrifuge. What else do we need to go with that? So let's just check combustion centrifuge. Two steel sheets, one cable coil. So I'm going to need a load of cable coil anyway, so it should you. Ah. Do I have any more cable coils on me? I don't think I do, and I think I'm out of copper. I've got a whole 3 grams of copper there, so I need to go and get some copper. Okay, well, we can make a start on this. I have some steel sheets on me. There's no copper there. Just iron, and there's no copper in there. So as I was saying, I'm going to put it around here. Let me just get it the right way. That's that way. If I bring it over. It's too far to there. We will run the chutes in that side. This gives me space here. Actually, now I'm going to put a vending machine here rather than inside the building. And that run the power in from the back. So I need you and you to begin with. And now I need a cable coil. You know what? I have a cable coil here. Let me just take one for now. Where'd it go? Oh, lost it. It's fallen down the hill. Come back. The gravity gets me every time, I lack a bit. And there we go, that's the centrifuge set up effectively. I say it's set up, it needs power. Where's the power going in? If I stop flying away too far. Ah, power is over there. So I will, in fact, take this cable out this way, because it's actually in my way currently. Too many games, keep getting the wrong keys. Jetpack on. You can come this way. To you to there. I will build a vending machine here somewhere. So I'm going to need power down here. Now I can run the power from here across into the deep miner, but I need to get some copper first. So I'm just going to go back inside my base quickly to vent off some gas. No, I don't mean fart. I mean my waste tank. What has that done to my atmosphere? Okay, it's still good. You wait, close you, bring you down waters, 59, food 60, that's fine for the moment. How can I need a bath? I've literally just taken a shower, I need the other one already. What do I want to do? I want to, turn you on in a minute, I need some copper. So let's go mine some copper, I'll be back shortly. And if you're wondering how much better this drill is, I just look at this for example. Literally just about walking straight forward here, digging, so compared to how I was doing it before, where I was having to keep going over areas to dig them out, now I literally just point the drill in the right direction and walk forward and it digs a hole. This drill is so much better than the previous one. So I've just been mining and I've inadvertently, as going up the surface, I've inadvertently mined under my base. So I need to head back down again, try and come out somewhere other than under my base. So which way did I come in? This way. So I've just mined out all that silicon that was under my base. As I said, I wasn't going to mine, I just mined it inadvertently. Because you can travel so far through the ground with this drill, it takes no time at all. Right, so turn you off, turn you off. And as you can see, I've got pretty much a full load of ore here. Not quite, but not far off it. Right, which way is my base? Not far away. Oh, there it is. Totally wasn't far away. Right, so now we've got loads of ore. I need to smelt some copper. So just get rid of that gas in the furnace. And then my ladder's running down. I will drop a couple loads of copper into there. And just fire up the furnace. That should be enough. And there we go. While I was there, I also got 100 gold. Now we've run that through. I also got enough material to make another 200 steel. Hundred silicon. Wet skin across the floor like that, and 100 straight iron. And now I can leave that gas off. Just going to do a quick check, make sure my tanker in the back isn't about to go pop. I don't think it is. No, it's way off. It's fine. Right, let me just do another quick look at these solar panels. Now the sun is more or less on them. 130, yeah, it's about 140 watts. Okay, so it might be worth trying to get a tracking panel up there and see what that does. Right, what did I need? I need some cabling. Let's grab us 30, maybe it's 40 cabling. How are we doing over here? You're okay. You're turning off and on. You are 5.5. Okay, that's fine. Oh. Where's the iron? Iron ingot. That should do. There's one bounced off me somewhere, I think. It'll turn up. Turn you on, turn you off. And I want some chutes.
14. 15.
Vending machine, what do you need? Steel, electrum, solder. Steel. Electrum and solder. Is that enough? Oh, not enough electrum. For electrum, I need gold and silver. How much gold have I got there? 47, you'll do, and I believe I've got 40, 50, yeah, so, 47 there. Okay, let's turn you off for the minute, turn you off. What temperature does electrum need to be? Above 600 and but quite low pressure. Above 600, quite low pressure. So there is that. What we at? Pressure's too high. Hydration critical. 2.4, I think it is. There we go. Let me just turn it off for now, save some power. There's the electrum, turn you on. Vending machine. Quickly print one of them while I sort out my water. Food first. And I know my batteries just run out. Got any cereal bars left? Yes, I do. And I do need to expand the space. I've got so many more things I need to build in here. Water, how are we doing? 27 litres still. Is that printed? That's printed. What does a vending machine need? To build a vending machine kit. Yeah, vending machine can store a lot of stuff. One vending machine, two plastic sheets and a screwdriver. So I need some plastic, which I have here. I'll swap out for the steel, and I don't need the glass on me either. What I do want to do is swap that. So I'll turn my suit light off. How's that one doing? 54, I'll swap that one out as well. Right, let's go and build some bits. I had to pick up that tonight, yeah. Turn you off. Actually. Let's get the centrifuge done first. Not the centrifuge, the cabling. I knew what I meant. Thank you. due to there. Come across here. That could very quickly drain my battery. Shoots. Let's see, can we bring the chute? Way. Ah. Damn, I can't take it past the cable. Okay, I did wonder if I could do that. That's right, it's another way around it. Yeah, 11 shoots, wasn't too far off. There we go. So that will now be kicking out material into here. Actually, let me... No, don't throw that away. On a window. So if I can see if there's anything in there. So what I need to do now is get some pipework and a cowling. Now the vending machine, let me just bring a vending machine down. Do I want it out here? There's nothing on that side. So I can have it. I could have it there. Run the pipe. Pipe's going to get snarled up on that, isn't it? I'll have to bring a pipe around here. Oh, no. I need more space. Bring it out one. Take the pipe across there then. Okay. Then I need plastic. And screwdriver. Oh yeah, don't need additional materials here. That's it. And now cabling. Into there, you're across there, so I've got power into there. I will, just for sake of doing it, why are you in? I don't need you, or you just go back to a normal corner. I was trying to see how much power I had. Which one's the input? Output. Input. So I'm going to have to bring the pipe down around here and then just bring a pipe out here for the gases. So I'm going to need quite a few insulated pipes, which is why I got some more silicon. Steel. insulated pipes. Yeah, I'm probably going to need 20 or 30 of these easy. Just bear with me. So I've managed to print off 40 insulated pipes, which I'm hoping enough. I've also printed off a cowl and an insulated passive vent. Maybe better put an insulated passive vent on here to stop the gases forming in the pipe. I'm now just trying to work out the best way to run this pipe work. I think actually can I bring it round that way? Probably not actually. So let me just take it this way. That's one load of 20 pipes gone. That didn't take long. And I'm going to take this down a little bit. Actually, let me take that to there, then put you there. That means I've got to take you down to here. Will I have enough pipes? I should do. Not the best routing of pipes, but it gets me what I need. So we now have a output, so fuel coming in and a vent for the gases going out. The only thing I'm missing is this corner that way. Will I have enough? No, I'm going to be one short. Rats. Right. Let's get that turned on anyway. And get this started. So this is a challenging part, starting up this vent. This combustion centrifuge. I'll run through it with you once. So you can see what you've got to do. But it's better to actually get a program to do it. So one is the amount of fuel, and the other one's the blower. And you've got to balance these without overstressing the system. And you've got to do a stage process. So you see a green box, top and bottom, that moves them up, that moves them down. So move one up, let's get it started. Do them both one, and then just watch the stress go up. You just got to wait while that stress rises. It will eventually peek out and start coming back down again. It'll sound like a bucket of nails while it's doing it. Stress is still going up. You see the temperature 1.2K. Or kilo K, should I say. And the stress is now coming back down again. Let's let that drop down into the green zone. And now take them both up by another notch. And you notice as you're doing that, the RPM is slowly increasing. The pressure is increasing and the temperature is increasing. Stress has come right down, so let's take a couple notches. Don't be tempted to try and go too quick, else you'll overstress the system. The stress has started to go back up again. Do it very slowly this time. Stress is still slowly climbing. And now it's starting to come back down. And now just final two clicks on either side. Stress should remain low. The RPM should increase just with the pressure. And if we look over this side, we can see we're processing dirty ore. So dirty ore comes in and is processed into usable ore. So in this case we've got iron, gold, copper, hydrocarbons, silver, lead and silicon. And that is all what that mine is pulling out the ground. So with a couple of deep miners and one of these, you don't actually need to go mining that much anymore. But I haven't got enough to run two of these yet, because that would be 1 kilowatts of power. Let's move away from that, it's incredibly noisy, sorry about that. Stress is zero, yeah, that's going flat out now. And you can let that run until the total quantity of refined ores is near to 1,000. And then we'll shut it down. Shutting it down can be a bit tricky. And you can see there we've got dirty ore waiting to go into the centrifuge. So we just wash and it consumes those last four there. Processing 3, 2, 1, 0. And it will now, just taking another batch of 12 in, so we've got plenty of ore in the pipeline to feed it. Yeah, that's good. You got nothing in you, I need to go and get a chute. So yeah, get away from that, because it's noisy as hell. And then we build a room around it, just to cut out the noise. And shoot. Where do you think you're going? Go over there. Print 2 as a reason for this. Sorry for the noise. I'm going to put a window in here so that way I can see if the vending machine's full, there'll be ores stuck in here. Now I'll just quickly show you shutting this down, just to demonstrate it. It is very, very noisy. The best way is to just turn it off, pull the handle. You can see the door going there. And you can see ores shooting into here. And those ores are now in here. Oh, shut up, groany. So all those ores are now in here. Now, before you can restart it, there wasn't any ore left in there anyway. So what I might do is leave that for a few minutes, let the stress levels come back down again, and then start it back up. And if you've not seen this vending machine before, you click on the arrow to find the one you want. That tells you just to the right of the symbol, when you're over the arrow, what it is. So 1 cobalt, 5 silicon, 3 lead, 1 nickel, 2 silver, 15 coal, 9 copper, 5 gold, 27 iron, or well, back to 1 cobalt. It just loops around. And I believe this can hold 60, or is it 100? Might be 100, hold on a minute. 100 stacks, so it can hold 100 items. What it doesn't do is stack them inside itself, so that 1 cobalt is taking up 1 stack within the machine. That 27 iron is taking up just 1 stack within the machine. So you can have a maximum of 100 stacks in here, and to get them out, you select them, click vend, and they'll pop out the front there. Okay, how are you doing? Some more in there. Let's bring this all the way down, and I'll quickly restart this, I will not make you sit through it again. One thing that it did do is when you pull the handle, that allows it to release the oars. If you just turn it off, the oars will stay in here, inside here. You need to check them like you do the printers. So you've got to close that before you turn it back on. That's just accepted a dirty oar inside. And these are dirty oars. That's why they are this horrible browny, pooey colour. Right, let's get this going. Just as a note, if you let the stress get too high, so the stress gets up into the red, the system will lock up and the whole thing will grind to a halt. And you have to start again. It's starting it up once the stress is returned back to zero. So just be aware of that. Don't be tempted to try and increase these handles too quickly. Else you will just end up having to start all over again. Even while it's starting up, you can hear it taking in more ore, and you can see it's actually processing ore. So as soon as you turn it on, start processing the ore. And there we go, both handles full up, and stress is at zero, and we're now processing ore. Quite a lick. Didn't really need that cooling gas, that was the one I kept blowing up my base. Don't need that fuel. I do need some other bits. So these waste canisters here, something else you can do, I'll show you later, is you can use a recycler to chew these up and spit them out into a centrifuge, into the big round centrifuge, not the combustion centrifuge, and recover some ores from them. Yeah, it's not really worth it though, to be honest. Most of the time you're just better off throwing them away in the distance. Quick look on our plants, check how they are doing, and how our fuel's doing, our batteries. Okay. So we've still got coal there, so we've only used one lot of coal so far. We're probably about 50% charge across both batteries. We've got 200 watts coming in and 1.2 kilowatts going, so you're burning kilowatt at the minute. How's our plants doing? One potato seed, one potato seed, we'll take those and put them up here, replace them. And now we will take the potatoes and plant a couple more. And the others can go in our fridge. How is the soya doing? Thriving towards fruiting, that's good. And our wheat is thriving towards fruiting. We're going to need a lot more hydroponics. We're going to need at least 10 hydroponics just for the wheat. So I am going to have to expand my base out this way. I may make a stairwell down here and move the base down a bit. That's maybe something for the next session. But yeah, for today guys, I think I'm going to leave it there for now. It's been quite a good episode. We've got quite a bit done. We can see our combustion centrifuges running nicely from here without all the noise. And other thing I want to do next session, I didn't get around to doing it today, is create a tracking solar panel and see how much energy that gathers from the sun. Because obviously we have 8 wind turbines up there, and yeah, they're generating 1 kilowatt at the minute. So when you're pulling about 50 watts, that makes a change. Right, anyway guys, thanks for watching. Please hit the like and subscribe. Please leave any comments below. If you'd like to support my channel, you can do so by joining me or leaving me a super thanks. All proceeds go towards hopefully replacing my aging laptop. I do believe I've now got a dodgy power connection on this, so it's getting close to the point where it's going to be no longer usable. Thanks for watching guys, the Dragonfly Gamer wishing you good night.